So this is a short video about the types of hair follicle and certain numerical facts about hair. So coming to types of hair follicle, the first one is Lanugo hair. Let's see Lanugo hair and vellus hair together. So this Lanugo hair and vellus hair both are less than 30 micrometer in diameter, whereas this Lanugo hair can be more than 2 mm in length, whereas this vellus hair is less than 2 mm in length. So both of them does not contain medulla, and both are soft and poorly pigmented, and this Lanugo hair is the first hair to grow in utero, whereas this vellus hair, it grows throughout life. In certain type of hypertrichosis, Lanugo hair can be seen in adults, whereas in scalp 7-25% of hair can be vellus hairs, the remaining will be terminal hairs. So next one is intermediate hair. So this one is about 30-60 micrometer in diameter and more than 2 mm in length. It is mostly seen postnatally as scalp hair growth after the initial Lanugo hair growth. So how it differs from vellus and Lanugo hair is that it has a rough cuticle. There you have no pigmentation in vellus and Lanugo hair, whereas intermediate hair has sparse pigmentation, and also it has a fragmented medulla. So now coming to terminal hair, it is about more than 60 micrometer in diameter and more than 2 mm in length. So compared to the other types of hair, this terminal hair is large and pigmented, and the size and shape of terminal hair varies with the body location and function. So what are its functions? It protects from UV light, and also it acts as an insulation against heat and cold. So the eyelashes, they have the largest diameter of all the body hairs, and they have a strong pigmentation and short active growth phase. So this vellus hair, it penetrates the reticular dermis but does not go up to the subcutis. And also they have skirt like epithelial structures or perifollicular connective tissue capsule with clear space from the outer root sheath. So this space, it contains a mucinous substance containing nerve endings, fibroblasts and mast cells. So the dermal papilla, it usually contains 10 to 30 follicular cells in vellus hair. So whereas in terminal hair, the dermal papilla, it contains almost 200 to 400 cells, and they reach into the deep dermis, whereas the vellus hair, it does not reach into deep dermis. So this terminal hair, they are found in locations like scalp, eyebrow and eyelashes, beard and moustache, body, pubic and axillary hair. So this is the vellus hair and the terminal hair. If you see the terminal hair, it contains a cuticle, cortex and medulla, whereas this vellus hair, you have a cuticle and less cortex there, but there will be no medulla. So the sebaceous hair follicles, these are hair follicles associated with large multilobed sebaceous glands. And the shape of the inner root sheath, it determines the shape of the hair, whereas the dermal papilla, it determines the hair size. So the normal ratio of terminal hair is to vellus hair in scalp is around 7:1. So based on the angle, the types of hair include perpendicular, slight angle and marked angle. So this is the different types of shapes of hair. One is straight hair, and then kinky hair, and then the curly hair. So certain numerical facts about the hair follicles. So the hair growth per day is about 0.35 mm in the scalp. It is around 0.38 in the chin, in axilla 0.30. In eyebrows, it is the lowest, about 0.16 mm per day. The estimated number of follicles in head includes about 1 million follicles. In the trunk, it is 425,000. In arms, 220,000. And in legs, 370,000. So the total hair count is almost 5 million in our body, of which the scalp hair count ranges from 80,000 to 150,000 at any time. So the hair cycle ratio of scalp hair, at any point, 90% of hairs will be in anagen phase, 1% in catagen, and 10-15% in telogen phase. And the duration anagen phase lasts for about 2 to 6 years, catagen phase about 2 to 3 weeks, and telogen phase for 3 months. So you can remember it as anagen phase as 3 years, catagen phase as 3 weeks, and telogen phase for 3 months. So the physiological hair shedding per day is around 100 to 200 hairs per day. In a normal woman, the amount of hair shed will be around 50 to 150 hairs per day, whereas in men it can be 25 to 100 hairs per day. More than 200 hairs per day, you can call it as abnormal. So the hair shaft production rate in the scalp is about 0.35 mm per day or 1 cm per month. And the hair shaft pigmentation, dark hair contains eumelanin, whereas the blonde or red hair, it contains pheomelanin.